Hi, I'm Lex Raby of Lex Thomas.
And I'm Thomas Voorhees of Lex Thomas, and these are our favorite horror movies. I like this movie that came out a couple years ago, like 2008, called Outcast, and it's like a witchcraft movie in Scotland.
Yeah, there's a lot of magic, but it's sort of practical magic.
Yeah, like he needs to find out where somebody is, so we'll put a map on the ground and like break a crow's neck and the blood will drip like diagonally to hit the part of the map where they are. My next, Evil Dead 2, legendary movie, one of my favorites. It's one of the one like horror comedies that's able to combine, it's able to be funny without affecting the horror. The horror parts are just as scary and the funny parts are just as funny, and he's made this odd blend that usually doesn't work. Usually the comedy undercuts the horror, right, or vice versa. So it's sort of this unique piece. But there's this movie from the 80s called Pin that I like. A brother and sister are raised by a doctor dad who's got the fully articulated medical dummy with transparent skin. You're never sure whether this dummy's alive or not alive, and the son starts to get this really unhealthy relationship. And the father, the parents die, and then the kids like live with Pin in the house, and you gotta check it out. It's really gross and weird. I love The Fly. From the 80s. It's nice that it's like this love story between a guy and a girl as he's slowly transforming into a fly human monster. He just gets to more and gooier and slimier and more disgusting as the movie goes on, but it's actually like a little really affecting like love story at the same time as it goes. So
Goldblum.
And Jeff Goldblum is need, yeah. Poltergeist, it rules. It's like, it has this great setup of like super happy family, Spielberg-y feel,
yes,
stuff. So when the horror starts happening, it hits like way harder because you're not expecting it in this sort of nice, happy world. It Follows, which came out last year, so good. And it's all like sex horror, so it's like awful. The fact that you have to have sex with somebody to pass the curse.
Just a clean premise, though.
Such a good premise, because at all times you're terrified that this person could come walking up. You never know who it's going to be. Tokyo Gore Police.
Tokyo Gore Police.
Japanese, like, extreme horror. Someone will grab a bunch of zombies and within, like, 2 seconds assemble a zombie car to chase the bad guys. It's a little...
I want to see
it's not
that.
A little. It's a lot overwhelming. Society. That's a really weird old 80s horror movie about this like jock kind of guy just living around all these rich people, and it slowly is like this metaphor for the rich eating the poor, and it all ends in this like revolting body horror like orgy where all the people's bodies are like melting together and everything is it's amazing. Castle Freak.
I don't know.
No,
you don't have to say anything.
There's a castle freak. He's been like chained up by his mean mom his whole life, and then she dies.
Yeah.
And then he's unhappy about it. Nightbreed is such a good movie. The main character dies in like the first 10 minutes, and then it takes you into this underworld full of all these practical effects and crazy freak looking people. And it's like, it moves so fast. It's like, you just get little glimpses of what promises like there would be this giant world beyond it. And it makes you like wish there was more movies.
Yeah. Plus, Cronenberg is the bad guy.
Yeah.
Not a director.
He wears like a leather hood with two buttons over his eyes. Never explained how he can see anything or walk through a room.
Yeah.
But
that's
really Nightbreed rules. Yeah. If you want to know more about our thoughts on these movies, come to our blog at lex-thomas.com, and we watch 31 horror movies every October.
Yep.
Along with Daniel Krauss, the other YA horror author. He started it all, so go to our blog and check out the last 3 years of us
and
watching.
Join us next year.
Yeah, watch along with us next year.